So, just watched the Blade 2 movie. Wesley Snipes returned as Blade. Okay, so badass again. I feel really stupid not to have ever seen any of these movies. So basically, he's got a rescue Whistler. Whistler from the previous movie tried to kill himself or something, and it didn't work because the vampires before got to him and he didn't want to be in pain. But actually some vampires grabbed him captive, and Blade went to go rescue Whistler. So he went to go rescue Whistler, but Whistler is freaking with an assistant. He's not Whistler. Blade has an assistant named Josh. Josh, he's like a handyman, builds all this cool shit. You think Josh is cool, but then Josh at one point gets beaten up, and he like licks his blood, and you're like, gets suspicious, right? So Blade goes and has these people that go and bring him, not people, they seem like ninjas of sorts, like the third echelon, like of Splinter Cell. They got all these like crazy high-tech gadgets. It's just two of them. They're very, very silent. Ninja third echelon type characters. So Blade fights them, and they say, "Hey, we're part of the vampire clan or something, some big group to do with vampires." And then said, "We want to deliver you a message." So they ask if he can join a thing to fight carriers. And carriers is what this guy Jared Nomak is. He feeds on vampires, basically on anyone, vampires and humans. So Nomak, he's stronger, gets stronger bites. They essentially, Blade helps these characters and he goes and needs to fight the carriers. So there's a bunch of carriers and stuff, but spoilers, if you haven't seen the movie, I'm sorry, but I recommend you watch them because they're all good, really awesome. I've yet to watch the third one still. So yeah, they fight the carriers and stuff like that, and then one of the guys is like, "Oh, we have a question for you, Blade. Can you blush?" And he's like, "Oh, you think you're real funny, huh? Oh, now you've been plotting to kill me for years, and here's your chance." And Blade wrecks the dude, and puts a bomb on him and can detonate it at any time he feels like it. And basically, Blade goes and he fights with these people, fights the carriers, and God damn it. Sorry, friends calling. Told them I'll call him. And yeah, so he fights the carriers, and then it turns out that Josh was actually working with the bad guys and brings them to frickin' justice. Well, not justice, brings them to captive. And so they're gonna get Blade's blood or something, and Nomak is trying to get revenge, I guess, against the people who created him or something like that. And his father, which is like the almighty, like Yoda type guy of the movie, and except he's evil. And so, yeah. But the thing of it is basically he fights. He needs. He's getting. The guys he was working with were like all against him, pretty much, and Josh especially. And so that bomb thing. Supposedly he's like, oh, that bomb. It was actually a dud, and he took it out of the one guy's head. That guy's like, girl, can you blush? And then freaking Josh is holding it. And then he's like, oh, this was a bomb. It was to make you feel like you're in control. And then he's like, oh, well, little do you know, it wasn't a dud. He's like, oh, shit. Just blows up. Just, and yeah. And then, so basically, Blade gets rescued from Whistler. Whistler was in captive as well from the guy who said, can you blush? And Whistler cuffs the handcuffs and freaking gives it, takes out that one guy, this bald guy. And, but yeah, also, another thing is, earlier in the movie, they have going through a cave system, which is like carrier heaven, so, or haven, if you will, whatever. And Josh made these ultraviolet grenades. That basically blast off ultraviolet beams that will take out, pretty much any form of vampire, especially the carriers. So, yeah, they do that, and that's a pretty crazy scene that quite a few of the people he was teaming up with were ended up dying or some shit like that. So, but. Yeah, so Blade needed to basically fight the people he was supposedly supposed to work with. Josh ended up getting what he deserved, 'cause fuck Blade over, so that's what you get. And then, yeah, so crazy shit, and Blade's just wrecking dudes, just fucking shotgun blast, or not one of shotguns, it sounded like a mini Uzi. He's just like, just take them all out. They're all just going, fucking crazy. And then, yeah, so again, movie's awesome. It's got sound. Some of the songs that's got in it is the Crystal Method, the name of the game. Fucking fight scene, amazing. He fights like 30 guys, dude. Amazing. Then there's also it's something cowboy. It's with Cypress Hill. It's like something cowboy, but they're in a club, and it's it's good. That's when the people they want to work with them are bringing them in. And also at the club, a bunch of carriers come up, and that's where they figure out the ultraviolet rays work. Silver bullets don't work. Garlic doesn't work. None of that works. Stabbing them, stakes, whatever. So yeah, that's my review of the Blade movie. Awesome fucking movie. Awesome soundtrack. Blade's awesome. Fucking truly badass. Wesley Snipes is amazing. There's one guy in it though that who says, "Can you blush?" I can't remember who it is, but Blade ends up fighting him at the end. And yeah, a pretty intense fight scene. Then he needs to fight Nomak, or no, yeah, Nomak, because Nomak, he's like the ultra. He's the carrier of the origin of the carriers. He's the origin of the carrier disease. So yeah, awesome movie. And if you haven't seen Blade 1 or 2, definitely fucking watch them. Crazy, awesome movies. Best vampire action movies. The special effects are great. The way the vampires die, there's ultraviolet rays, like, it blaze killing and stuff, and it's just awesome. Just fucking, just check it out. crazy. Fuck yeah.